Hey guys, as I promised before, here is the follow-up to my RTX 5090 Oros Extreme review. In today's video, I'll be comparing the Oros Extreme pre-installed radiator fans, which are set up as exhaust against a set of Lianli fans. Specifically, I went with the Unifan TL120mm LCD wireless, standard blade, not the reverse one. Also, they are all set in exhaust configuration. The reason I chose these Lianli fans is simple. They complete the look I was going for, and the Oros stock fans that came with the GPU just weren't doing it for me. They don't look bad, but let's be real, the blade's material look kinda plasticky and flimsy, and also the RGB looks slow and way more limited in effects compared to what Lianli offering. I believe the fans Oros ships with those rods uses their Easy Chain Fan 120 models. They have the Easy Chain connection and also have like a connector at the end for the final fan that can feed other fans with power, etc. Now let's take a quick look at the specs for both fans. The Oros Easy Chain Fan 120 uses a hydrodynamic bearing, or HDB for short. It's a solid choice for pre-installed fans and does the job well enough. It spins up to 2000 RPM, delivers about 60 CFM of airflow, and pushes a static pressure of 2.75 mmH2O. Now the Lianli Unifan TL120mm LCD wireless steps up things up a bit with the fluid dynamic bearing, FDB for short. While HDB and FDB sound similar, FDB has the edge, especially when it comes to noise levels at higher RPMs. It's designed to reduce friction more efficiently, making it quieter and smoother under load. So right off the bat, just from the bearing type alone, the Lianli fans already bring a noise advantage. So yeah, on paper, the specs are almost identical, but as you will see in a second, the real world difference is actually kinda wild. Both spin up to 2000 RPM, airflow is just a touch higher on the Lianli at 62 CFM compared to 60 on the Oros fans, and static pressure is slightly better too at 2.9 versus 2.75 mmH2O. Nothing that screams game changer at first glance, but once you see them in action, that small spec gap turns into a noticeable real-world difference. Now the Oros fans are controlled via Gigabyte Control Center, you've got your usual auto mode, and of course, you can customize the fan curve. Minimum speed is 600 RPM, and they can also be turned off completely, but when turned on, they can't spin below 600 RPM. And in my case, they can max out at 1800 RPM. On the other hand, the Lianli fans are managed through L-Connect, and what's great is that you can still set them to follow your GPU temps directly. This way they are fully synced in speed with the GPU temp, and they also have 0 RPM mode, and I believe their minimum RPM is 350. Alright, let's get now into the actual testing. Running both setups in 4Mark side by side, we got consistent power consumption of 600 watt. With both running at 100% speed for 10 minutes, here is what we've got. For Oros fans, GPU temp is 57.5, while VRAM temp is 70 degrees. Now if we switch to Lianli TL LCD wireless fans, GPU temp this time is 54, so a reduction of around 3.5 degrees. As for VRAM temp, it's 66, so they have been reduced by 4 degrees compared to Oros fans. That's a solid 3.5 to 4 degree drop on both GPU and memory temp just from swapping the fans. And that's not bad at all considering we are at 600 watt. Let's now compare noise in real time with both set at fixed speed of 700 RPM. So you shall be the judge in this test. Thank you. While the overall system noise didn't really change, the sound levels were pretty similar across both setups, whether at 700 RPM or at full speed. But the Li and Li fans definitely sounded cleaner at max RPM, probably thanks to their FDP pairing compared to the HDP ones on the Aorus fans. Let me know which one sounded better to you. Maybe it would have made more sense to isolate the radiator fans, like turning off the other case fans, to get a cleaner noise comparison. But I wanted this to reflect a real-world scenario, with all case fans running at their normal speed, just like how you would actually use the system day to day. I also did a bit of real-world testing too. First, I have set Li and Li fans speed to 700 RPM, and in most demanding games, while pulling 600 watts from the GPU. At that low speed, the GPU stayed super silent, and temps didn't exceed 58.5 degrees for the GPU and 78 degrees for the memory. Now yeah, that's warmer than max fan speed, but still well within a safe zone. Then I cranked the fan speed to 100% and the temps dropped significantly. The GPU stayed under 52 degrees all along and VRAM was at 70 degrees Celsius. That's around 8 degrees drop overall. Of course, running at max fan speed isn't ideal for noise or daily use, but setting the fans to auto or around 1200 to 1300 RPM gave me a perfect balance between acoustics and cooling. Also keep in mind that in all those tests I have done, I had my overclocking settings applied. They are plus 150 MHz on the core and plus 6000 MHz on the memory. If you want to learn more about how I did that, watch the full guide linked in the suggested video here. So finally, I would like to ask you, what do you think of the results you have seen here? Did you expect that kind of temperature drop just from swapping out the fans? We had the same fan orientation, same speed, yet noticeably better temps. Honestly, the Aorus stock fans aren't bad at all. They'll be fine for most cases. But if you want to squeeze out better thermals, going with a more premium fan, in my case, the Li and Li TL, can make a real difference. I'm pretty sure if we slapped it with some Noctua fans, we'll see some crazy results. But anyway, this was just a small taste that I wanted to share with you all. I hope it gave you some useful insight. So if you enjoyed the video, smash that like button. And if you haven't already, please subscribe as there is more to come real soon. Thanks for watching and see you in the next one.